Hello everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. In the last part I showed you a little bit of level 5, so now without further ado, let's go get these towers I was talking about. This is actually the smallest tower in level 5, but it's very much worthwhile. These mudmen alone, I believe these are the gold spawns at the start here. Yep. Drop 1,000 gold each, so yeah. These guys by themselves would make this tower almost worth it. Now a good thing about these mudmen is that they move in straight lines, so you'll be able to attack them from the side if you want to get your melee experience up a little bit. I don't really care about that, so I'm just going to shoot them with my magic. Oops. Oh well. 3,000 damage feels like a lot, but at this stage it really isn't. I mean, any damage you can avoid is beneficial, of course, but yeah. Okay, now these snowmen will do a lot of damage to us, but they drop poison anyway, so let's just get rid of them quickly. Oops. Shot a box, but oh well, these are just normal boxes, so it's not that big a deal. Let's clear out this top room first. These Taropers are... they don't move, but they're very strong, so best to use your magic attacks to kill them. Especially because they drop gold anyway, so you don't really need to kill them with your melee weapon. And of course it's always nice to get a free Madoc. Now another one of the reasons why I told you at the beginning of this Let's Play that I want to get my fighter experience up in the early levels is because the further you get, the more you're going to be using your magic attacks, because these critters are going to be stronger and stronger, and our armor and defense aren't going to rise as quickly as their attack stats do. So, long story short, that means we are going to be using more magic as we level up. Already you can see that my wizard experience is getting close to matching my fighter experience. Even though it's only been since the previous level that I've started to use my magic attacks more. Yeah, we want to definitely kill this guy with our normal weapon, because they are... they drop pendants. And pendants are even more valuable than stuff like keys. There we go, pendant. Have to pick up the little gold boxes as well. This tower is going to cost us a few keys, but it's definitely going to be worth it. And the reason for that is in this room. Yep. Now these myconids, yeah, these are the good ones that you want to kill with your regular attack. 23,000 damage. These guys are crazy. But a Madoc is a Madoc. A Madoc is more valuable than a full heal, so it's definitely worth taking some damage to get a Madoc. A +2 large shield. That's what we came here to get. Much better. Our defense now is 6,400, and it was, with our previous shield, 5,800, so even without experience, our new shield is much better than the one we had. And we are definitely going to be needing it. And this is the second reason why this tower is very nice to clear. It has a lot of pendants. And pendants open doors for us, literally. And another Madoc as well. So 3 Madocs, 4 pendants, a lot of gold, and a +2 shield. This is a very nice tower, especially because you can do it in very little time. Here we go. So without wasting too much time, let's head straight for the next tower, because that's the one we really want to get. There's even more interesting stuff down there. You get there by falling down this... Oh jeez. Okay, I shouldn't have done that, because this is one of those places where you will get completely and utterly stuck. This place is... yeah, there's no way to get out of here unless you prepare the exit down below. So This is one of those places I was talking about. It's just game over from here. You have to reset and restart. So I'm just gonna pause the video and get back to where we were and come back to you guys. Okay, see you then. Okay, thankfully it saved after I re-entered this tower, so I didn't have to redo everything. Saves us a little bit of time. Okay, so like I was saying, to get to the second tower from here, you walk off this side and then you walk into the last of the exits to the left. And then what you do is, we have a couple of traps here, because of course these anvil things, you can't get back up if you go down. So you have to take the correct exit. Now the way to remember this is that the final one is not the one you want. This is one of the traps. And from there, every other one is either good or bad. So this one is bad, this one is good, this one is bad, this one is good, and this one is kind of bad. It doesn't get you stuck, but it doesn't get you where you want to go either. So don't take this one, either take this one or this one. And we'll see in a second why that is. See, so if I'd gone down the middle one, I would have ended up here, and I'd have to waste another Madoc to open that blue brick. So this is the second tower, and there's another Steroper up here as well, so we probably want to kill that one soon. But let's get to the tower first. So let's get started. Now in this tower there's a couple of good things you want to pick up, and the first of those is that there is a bunch of creatures that give you Madocs if you kill them with your melee weapon. And this is actually one of them. Or this group. Yeah. Definitely worth taking like 5, 10 or so thousand damage to get these guys to give you a Madoc. There we go. There's a couple of more if we go to the top or the right over here, but the real item I wanted to show you in this dungeon is something a little bit more special. And it's over this way. First get these guys out of the way. These guys are also worth killing with your melee weapon because they drop pendants. Pendants are very valuable, almost as good as, well, maybe not as good as Madocs, but mostly because Madocs are just for very specific uses. And there's really no alternative for them. Whereas pendants, you can just use a key instead. Some giant striders. Now, these don't drop the best item. I think it's a lamp or something. But any fighter experience you can get at this point is going to be worth it. So if you find any creatures that are easy to kill with your normal attacks, do it. In levels 1 through 4, it's been, well, 1 through 3 at least, it's been very easy to get fighter experience. But as we level, as we go deeper into the dungeon, it's going to get harder and harder. Just because monsters have a very strong melee attack too now, so and we can't really upgrade our armor very much anymore. So it's going to be very rough on us to kill everything with our sword or whatever you're using. Snowman, I happen to know, will drop poison, so we might as well just use our magic to kill them. And the next room is the item I wanted to show you. First we're going to have to kill whatever guards it, which I happen to know is Myconids. Again, insane damage from these guys, so be really careful. Now these guys drop Madocs as well, but since we're so close to death, yeah, we're going to just kill them outright. This is a broadsword, not really useful at this level. Even if you hadn't upgraded your weapon that much, you're going to at least have something better than a broadsword by level 5. But the real item we wanted to show you is this one. It's a white pendant. It looks very much like the other ones we were collecting earlier, but it's special because the white ones are similar to the red hammers, which you might remember gave us extra strength. This one increases our intelligence. So our int right now is 65. After I pick the thing up, we now have 75 intelligence, so yeah, very much worth it. Okay guys, that's really what I wanted to show you in this tower. We have a little bit of more time, so I guess I'll take out these guys. To show you that these are also worth sticking with your melee weapon, because they drop keys. So yeah, a lot of good items in these towers. Whereas level 4 was kind of crappy where the towers were concerned, level 5 has some very nice ones. Similar on this side. Don't want to get shot if we don't have to. And this should give us another key.
Yep.
And some more experience for a tilt spell. So yeah, very nice. Like I said, the top half is still worth clearing out. I'm probably going to do that off screen because we're running out of time for this video. Yeah, definitely clear the top part of this tower as well. There's an hourglass, a few medocs, and some other stuff that's, it's not vital, but it's going to be very useful. So yeah. Okay guys, thanks for watching. In the next part I will, or before the next part, I will probably play ahead a little bit more again. I'll clear out a bunch of the creatures from the overworld map. I'll try and get our armor upgraded to full plate, and I will meet you back when it's time to clear out the final tower for this level, the big one. Okay guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next part.